Death Guard are often accompanied in battle by vast hordes of Poxwalkers, diseased, corrupted humans dedicated to the plague god Nurgle. Now, in this video, we're going to show you a fantastic method of painting these miniatures really quickly that will have these huge units on the tabletop in no time. But as well as that, it's a really easy method to do as well. So if you're new to the hobby, this will be a fantastic one to follow. So without further ado, let's get started. Whilst in this video we're going to be concentrating on painting just one miniature, what I recommend you do with yours is paint them in batches. So by that I mean pick 5, 10 or even all 20 that you get inside Dark Imperium and paint them in a kind of production line. So start with the first step on one miniature and work your way through all of them, then move on to the second step and work your way through all of them and so on. And you'll find doing them in this way is the most efficient way of painting units that there is. Now for the first thing you need to do is undercoat your miniature, and for that what I recommend you do is spray them with Corax white spray, which is what we've done here. And then we're ready to start out with the main feature on these miniatures, which is their skin. Now for this all we need is a Thonian camo shade, which is a shade, and what you need to do, like all other paints, is give it a good shake before you start to use it. And then we're going to be applying quite a lot of this, so you need a medium shade brush to apply it. And what you do is get a good amount of this paint on your brush and put it onto a palette here like this, so you can control exactly how much you have on your brush at once. And what you want to do is get plenty of it loaded up and just start painting it all over the skin. And as it goes on, you'll see it runs immediately into all that recessed detail and makes it stand out nicely. Now, once you paint this all over the skin, you need to give the miniature plenty of time to dry. Around about an hour is a good idea when you're applying this much. And also keep an eye on it as it dries to make sure the shade isn't pooling too much towards the bottom of the miniature. If it is, just move away the excess paint with your brush. The shade's now completely dry, and you can see what a fantastic effect it's had on that skin, making all that detail stand out nicely. And with that done, we're now ready for the next step, which is to start painting in all the clothes. Now for our example here, we're just going to use Mournfang Brown now, but there's quite a variety between all the Poxwalker miniatures. So at this step, it's nice to add in some other colours as well, depending on which miniatures exactly you're painting. Now in our Lord of Contagion video, we used quite a few other colours on the Plague Marine, so you could at this stage add in some Screamer Pink, or Mechanicus Standard Grey, or Abaddon Black, and doing so will tie these miniatures in nicely with the Plague Marines, but the choice really is yours. Now for the Mournfang Brown, we're going to be applying this using a medium layer brush, and what you want to do is just get some of this paint and pop it onto your palette, and then add a small amount of water to it to thin it down so it's nice and smooth. So mixed in like that, and you're looking for about that sort of consistency before you start applying it to your miniature. And when you're ready, you're just looking to pick out all the fabric here and also all the leather. So I'm going to go for all the trousers and the belts down here, but also I'm going to pick out the cord going around the neck just up there, and also these straps on the weapon up there. And I will be applying two thin coats of this colour to make sure it's got a good strong finish before we move on to the next step. Once you're happy with all the clothes, we have two further base colours to apply, and the first of these is going to be Zandri Dust. Now this is for any bone that you can see on the miniature, also the maggots and any guts if there are any. And after that we're going to use Lead Belcher, and this is for all the metal things such as the weapons. But we're going to be starting out with Zandri Dust, applied mostly with a medium layer brush, but this time it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand because you will need it for some of the finer details. As previously, make sure you thin your paint down on your palette so it's nice and smooth. Again, you want about that sort of consistency. And when you're ready, you just need to start picking these details out. And I'm going to start out with these horns up on top of the head here. Next, we're going to apply Lead Belcher to all the metal parts. So you're looking at the weapons, but also be sure to catch any of the little buckles, chains, and also pendants as well. Now that we've finished applying all those base colours, we're ready to shade them. And for this, we're going to use Agrax Earthshade, but this time we need much more control over the shade. So I'm going to apply it using a medium layer brush. And, well, this is why it's so important that you use a palette with shade, because now you can control exactly how much you're applying at once. So you want a good amount in your brush, not loads and loads. When you're ready, all you've got to do is paint this over the new base colours that you've added, just being really careful when you get close to that skin. At those points, just be as neat as possible, and remember to give it plenty of time to dry. Now the shade is dry, we're ready to add some blood to our Poxwalker, and for this what you need is Blood for the Blood God, which is an unusual paint in that you don't have to water it down. However, for the use we're going to do here, it's a good idea to do so because we want quite a lot of control on it. So what I'm going to use is a small layer brush to apply this, and just get a small dollop of it on your palette there like that, then add in a small amount of water just to thin it. You're looking for about that sort of consistency before you apply it. And what we're looking to do here is to paint it into all the wounds and sores and onto all the boils and things. So for an example here, we've got a great big sore just there that's open. So what I'm going to do is paint the paint into it like that, and then just run it down the front. There we go, like that. I'm also looking for any boils, just paint over there like that. And so you can add as much of this or as little of this as you like from this point. Now, the blood for the blood gun is dry. All we need to do to complete our Poxwalker is base it. And for this, what we're going to do is apply some Agrellum Badland. Now, this is a texture paint, so what you need to apply this is one of these texture spreading tools. And what you do is get a shovel side just to get a scoop of that paint. Then on your base, all you've got to do is spot a more open area that's easy to access. The front of it's perfect for that. What you do is just put the dollop on there like that and use the tool to start moving the paint around, switching around to the narrower end for a little bit more control as you get close to the miniature's feet. Now, once you've applied this, give it plenty of time to dry. About an hour should be fine. And then all you need to do is paint the rim of the base. And for this example, I'm going to do that using a Baden Black. And with the base fully painted, this Poxwalker is ready to join the rest of the Horde and shamble towards the weakling defenders of the Imperium. So in this video, we looked at a fantastic way of painting your Poxwalkers quickly and getting them on the tabletop. When you're doing this, there are a couple of things to remember. And the first is that when you're painting all the skin with a shade at the beginning, just keep an eye on that shade as it settles and dries. Make sure if it pulls towards the bottom, you just move away that excess paint with your brush before it's all dry. Then when you're painting in the clothes, remember you can do as many colours here as you want to. We just used Mournfang Brown, but what I recommend you do is use other colours you've used on your Plague Marine so that all these miniatures match together, that you get a nice random shambolic appearance to your miniatures as well. And finally, when you're applying the shade to all those remaining base paints, just remember to be careful as you apply the Agraxur shade. Don't put on too much at once because you don't want to lose control of it and get it on the skin and ruin that cool green effect that we had on that. But there you go. I really hope you guys have enjoyed this video and learned something from it, and we'll see you all again very soon.